Now, before we wrap this project up, I want to take a minute to connect some of the ideas that we've seen in this lesson thus far. We started out by creating squares, and we wrote a piece of code that said, Brad is equal to turtle.turtle. What we were really doing behind the scenes there is creating an object or an instance of the class turtle. What we could then do with that instance is things like brad.forward. We then wanted to do things like read contents from a file on our computer. So we wrote a piece of code that said quotes equal to open a file location. What we were really doing behind the scenes there is create an object of the type file. We could then do things with that object like quotes.read. And when we wanted to access a website on the internet, we wrote a piece of code that said connection is equal to urllib.urlopen. Now this piece of code also returned a file-like object or instance, and we could then do things with that instance, like connection.read. In all three of these examples, we created instances or objects, and then we used those objects. Now, some of you may say that in the profanity editor example, all we used were functions. Functions like open and urlopen, and that there was no class like we saw in the previous example with turtle. Well, even though on surface it looks like we did not use any classes in the profanity editor example, if we look at how functions like open and urlopen are actually implemented in Python, we will find that some classes init-like function is being called to return these objects. Okay, let's look at one more example of how to use classes. Things will get a lot clearer after that.